Good evening, everybody, and welcome once again here to Oliver C. Dawson Bulldog Stadium here in Orangeburg, South Carolina, for tonight's MEAC Football digital broadcast on ESPN, featuring the Spartans of Norfolk State and the Bulldogs of South Carolina State. Hello, everybody. I'm Dee Hansen, joined by my broadcast partner in Steve Foster. Steve, this is a game between two MEAC conference teams, but because of Hurricane Florence, we are playing this game as a non-conference game between Norfolk State and South Carolina State.
Well, the hurricane also disrupted Norfolk State in their game against James Madison, where the game had to be stopped in the second quarter. James Madison up 17-0. That gave the Spartans their lone loss of this season after the second quarter. South Carolina State, the Bulldogs, they finished 8th in the MEAC last year. They're 0-2. They played two quality opponents in Georgia Southern and Central Florida, and tonight looking to get into the win column.
A couple players to look at for both of these teams. First, for Norfolk State, their offensive lineman and Craig Rodwell.
Rodwell, the offensive lineman of the week for the MEAC. He's a junior, and he opened up a lot of holes for Aaron Savage, who rushed for 112 yards against Virginia State. And then on the flip side, in South Carolina State, you have the quarterback, Tyrese Nick, and he's rushed for 178 yards in the first two games, and will look to use his legs to get a win against Norfolk State this evening.
It's Norfolk State on the road, and South Carolina State here at home looking for their first win of the season. Come on back right here on ESPN. Back here at Bulldog Stadium, and yep, Buddy Poe in his 17th season and his final season as the head coach at SC State with 120 wins. He is 10-3 against Norfolk State and an alum of SC State as well. 1975. Get ready for the kickoff here from Bulldog Stadium. Dee Hansen joined by Steve Foster here on ESPN. Thanks for joining us here this evening for this MEAC tilt. And it was South Carolina State that won the coin toss, elected to defer. So they'll be kicking off here to a Norfolk State team, an offense that runs the spread. They're 1-1 on the season, and it's powered by Aaron Savage. You talked about him a little bit too, Steve, and we'll watch him to start out this football game more than likely against a team in SC State's. Their defense has struggled a bit here to start out the year at 0-2.
Absolutely, and don't forget about second-team All-MEAC, Marcus Taylor, the wide receiver.
Well, here's that kickoff now, and the sun may be a factor here to start out. And returning it left-hand side. Nice get back there, almost to midfield on the return. And that sunlight, and it will be Norfolk State to get things going here against SC State, just starting out the first quarter of play.
And a great return to the 44, Dee Hansen, and that's percentage-wise very good for something to happen for the Spartans here. And remember, they're 1-1, so they've already got a W in the win column.
Yeah, neither of these two teams are prolific on offense quite yet this season, but Juwan Carter at quarterback, we'll watch him as well, out of Highland Springs, Virginia. Just a sophomore out of the shotgun. MEAC Rookie of the Week twice last year. And he'll hand it off to get things going. And that's a Savage again, and we're going to see a steady dose of that, I'm sure, during the course of this game.
Absolutely, and again, don't forget the line of scrimmage. The lines of scrimmage are going to be so important, and those guys up front. And South Carolina State can compete, and they've got to definitely take away the running lanes for a team we know that's going to keep the ball on the ground.
Heading to the left-hand side there. Also, don't forget Craig Rodwell. We mentioned him before, too. 6'4", 290, redshirt junior. That's second and 7 coming up here near midfield and finding a gap up the middle. There goes Savage again. And he will get a first down run right up the gut this time.
A nice little read inside and a great block at the point of attack. And then you just let your rusher pick and go 1 foot and up the field and a great gain to move the chains.
Redshirt junior, he's at 5'9", but don't let that confuse you. At 210, he's a bowling ball.
Compact.
Yeah. First down picked up on that last jaunt. And four showing here for South Carolina State, trying to make a dent in that offense, and a play action set up nicely. But there's the tip ball, which is just what the doctor ordered here for the Bulldogs. And that will bring up a second down after the incomplete pass.
Smart play by number 98, Bruce Johnson. If you cannot get to the quarterback, get your hands up. And the passing lane was then eliminated in a tipped ball. And the ball falls harmlessly to the turf, D. Hansen, with no gain.
Johnson, a senior, getting those mitts up, making a play. And you got trips to the right-hand side for Juwan Carter, who will look to the right, and he will get that complete to the 32-yard line. And that will bring up a second or third down. And short situation here.
Nice little timing play. Just get up the seam. Just really get a release from the line of scrimmage. Nobody in front of the receiver. And turn around quickly, catch the ball, lean and fall forward, and a manageable 3 yards for third down.
Juana Chuma with the reception. The redshirt junior leads the team in receptions, or reception receiving yardage at 82 on the season. First catch of the evening. Third and three coming up here, and it's a delayed draw, and nice defense. Bulldogs making a stand, able to make the play, is Quincy Hill, a freshman.
Actually, they double number. And if I'm not mistaken, apologies.
Kobe Durant. No, you're right. You're right.
Durant with a nice tackle. When you take the legs away, you can't churn, and that's fourth down.
Kind of a no man's land, though, here, Steve. So already decision time here for Norfolk State.
48-yarder if you're going to attempt a field goal, but I think you're correct. Go ahead and see if you can pick up a first down.
Here we go. It's a pass in the middle, and it will be deflected and nearly intercepted. Jumping in front of that one, Chad Gilchrist, the linebacker for the Bulldogs, and they get a turnover on downs.
Good defensive play there. Just sit in the back pocket of the receiver, and as soon as the ball comes, break on that ball, knock the ball away, or, as you mentioned, almost intercepted.
Another good receiver and all-purpose player, Marcus Taylor, the intended receiver on that last throw. 5'8 senior trying to sneak in there, but Chad Gilchrist gets the job done.
Sophomore did great there. Darius Leonard, the all-world second-round draft pick in the NFL, gone. He wore number 10.
So now it'll be South Carolina State's turn on offense for the first time. And this has been a tough road to hoe for this team. On the offensive side of the football, averaging 204 yards total on the year. And that's Tyrese Nick, though, we're going to watch him throughout the course of this game. The dynamic sophomore coming off of a good rushing game last time out. And he has 178 yards on the year.
Same high school as Chad Gilchrist.
Timeout taken. And we will go ahead and take it with him as well. Timeout taken on the field. You are watching MEAC Football here on ESPN.
Okay, you're Lee Corso.
Who?
Your coach.
ESPN College Game Day, built by the Home Depot.
They just ran a play. Okay. So that was Datron?
Correct.
And he gained what?
Three.
Okay, back here at Bulldog Stadium, D. Hansen and Steve Foster. We had a scheduled TV timeout, but I don't know if the official saw it right away. So South Carolina State did run a play 3 yards to the right-hand side to Datron James, the sophomore running back, and he gains around 3 yards. So that's where we sit now on the field, second down and seven.
You know I like to have 4 yards on first down or better.
I know that. I do know that.
I have gotten that through to you.
Finally.
Three's not bad. But you want to open that playbook. If you have 4 yards gained or more on first down, D, you can have a run-pass option. 3 yards, not bad as well. But you want to keep a defense guessing, especially when it's going to be heavy on the run side this afternoon.
Norfolk State's defense, we were highlighting the fact that, well, I guess it's a low light, actually. The two offenses have struggled. But the defense here for Norfolk State is the real deal. They're one of the better defenses last year, turning opponents over big time, plus 15 in that category. They're already at a roaring start at plus 2. And they are very good against the run, only giving up 94 yards per game.
All because they see the run in practice.
Right, like a lot. And they're going to see it a lot here today and tonight as Nick will throw it, though, and he'll complete it. And that is only a 7th completion of the season so far. Gets it to Will Vereen, and that will bring up a 3rd down and 3.
Manageable. You know, you always try to play games about it's not that far. It's only 9 feet. You know, you can broad jump 9 feet.
That's right.
But you can get somebody to get a head of steam upfield and fall forward.
Demo Burrows up in the upper portion of your screen, but instead they're going to hand it off up the middle, and that is going to be nothing doing as the Spartan defense comes up big and drives back James for minimal to no gain. There's that run again.
They did not listen to you about the defense, and it's tough running between the center and the guard, that A-gap, when you have such a strong defensive line, and the push was so good for the Spartans of Norfolk State, and they just shut down the running lanes.
Here comes Marcus Taylor. You got to watch out for him here on special teams. And he will be the one deep to receive on this punt, and he'll let it go smartly, and he'll be touched up at the 24.
Good punt. When you don't get any return back, especially when you're trying to flip the field. And getting the ball inside the 25 is a good opportunity, especially with the Bulldogs at home here, D. And as you mentioned, both of these defenses, very strong.
Any way you can keep Taylor from getting any kind of return is a good thing. He's number 6 in school history and tops among MEAC players last season when he averaged nearly 24 yards per return. And this guy is a dynamic returner.
A game changer.
Back on offense, Norfolk State for the 2nd time tonight. It will be, again, Carter out of the shotgun. And now they're going to play action that one. Tipped, it's still caught at the 40. I don't know how that happened, but it is, again, Awana Chuma with the reception, his 2nd of the night.
Well, it's a good play to tip the ball, but you don't want to tip the ball up because a wide receiver also in practice has tip drills as well, and great concentration there on the point of side of Norfolk State, and a good completion almost midfield. D.
Metchuma Awana, obviously, bursting those. And now already near midfield are the Spartans. Another play action, and again it is Awana with the reception down the right sideline and bounced out of bounds at around the 20. And really respecting the run are the Bulldogs, but the last two have been passes.
Well, 6'3", 210, good hands as you see, and I like the fundamental play of taking the ball into the opposite arm so you can keep defenders off you. Hey, don't need to go to the ground. A great gain for a first down.
Redshirt junior getting the job done through the air is Carter. Around 56% completion percentage. He's getting it through the air effectively now, and this time he'll be on the ground. Savage. First down and goal to go now as the, again, compact runner is right up the middle on the Bulldog defense.
Absolutely. And the change of plays. Pass can set up the run. That's what you saw there. And a great gain. Really, left side between the guard and the center. And a burst and a broken tackle brings Savage inside the 10.
It's Lyon getting the job done also here for Norfolk State. Knocking on the door, the closest either one of these two teams have gotten so far in this early stage of this game. And a floater, and that was meant for another area of the field. misreading that one. That'll be incomplete, obviously, intended for Isaiah Winstead, sophomore out of Richmond, Virginia. We'll bring a second down and goal to go coming up here for the Bulldogs. Excuse me, for Norfolk State.
Wasn't really a bad route, but the ball just sails out of the hands, as we saw, over everybody. And that's probably the safe play because good coverage in the secondary by the Bulldogs.
Well, you saw Winstead break in, and that was thrown out. So that's reading the coverage, right?
A lot of times you have that combination route where you read the defender.
Okay, well, a timeout is taken on the field. And you are watching MEAC football right here on ESPN.
Maytag was named the number one top load agitator washer by a leading consumer magazine.
MEAC action continues here at Bulldog Stadium. Dee Hansen and Steve Foster with you here on ESPN. Norfolk State looking for their first score on the road. They had two home games, and they're supposed to play at Liberty, but due to Hurricane Florence, here they sit with a away game for the first time in the season, and they're going for a score right now, unable to do so on that particular play, on that pass by Carter. But now third down and goal to go, still another down to go here for the Spartans.
Good coverage in the end zone, and you know, it's an advantage to a defense when you don't have a lot of field to cover. You can kind of show a zone man, sagging man to man. You talk about basketball some, but you can cover a secondary the same way and take away a lot of the opportunities.
Here's Juwan Carter again. He has been operating out of the shotgun all game long here in the second offensive series for the Spartans. And now he will look to the middle, and wide open is Winstead for the score. Touchdown, Spartans. They take the lead.
And a great design because the running back comes out of the backfield to the left, Dee Hansen, and Carter looks hard to that running back, and it allows the wide receiver to get in the end zone and kind of find a soft spot and a nice dart for a touchdown pass.
Carter with the second throwing score of the year. And that's Winstead's first touchdown of the season. Extra point coming up here for Josh Nardone. He is perfect so far on the year. And the sophomore will kick it through and make it a 7-0 game with 8:20 left here in this first quarter of play.
And right there, you can see in the replay, a nice pass, kind of not in the middle of the end zone, but enough in that soft zone that South Carolina State was playing, and Winstead settled in.
Something that I've liked to see this last couple drives, at least for Carter also, is how poised he seems to be. He doesn't seem like he has happy feet, takes full range of that defense, but he's had time. So the offensive line has gotten it done in both the run and the pass protection.
I would absolutely agree. No pressure in the face of Carter, and he had an opportunity to look off to his left, come back, and find a nice wide-open receiver. As you mentioned, in Winstead for the touchdown pass.
Norfolk State has had a tough time against South Carolina State in this series history. In fact, they had never beaten them until in 2016 when they came out here as well. November 12th, winning 13-10, and at that point they were 0-9 before that game. And we had mentioned before, too, about the Liberty game that Norfolk State was supposed to have on the 15th of September. That one postponed. Hurricane Florence postponing that Norfolk State game in Lynchburg. That has been rescheduled, though, tentatively for Saturday, December 1st. And it will be made up at Williams Stadium in Lynchburg at around 2 o'clock, unless the Spartans qualify for the postseason play before that, in which case they won't play the game.
A lot of flexibility there.
You'll have to reread that, yeah, because that's a lot of stuff. Here is the kickoff again by Nardone, and he will angle this to the far side of the field, and a modest return is... There's a lot of pushing and shoving now. And a little talking.
Yeah, always got to have a little bit of that. I like the directional kick there to the left side. Dee Hansen, it puts the return man in a box, so to speak, so you don't have to worry about getting out of your kickoff lanes. You can know to go to a certain side of the field, and its intent is to eliminate a big return because you put that return man on one side of the field and make him stay there.
Sean Baines, the freshman, 5'9", 200 pounds. Got a lot of that action there from that Norfolk State Spartan special teams. So now second offensive series, looking for a answer is the offense for the Bulldogs, and Nick will go into the air and be incomplete. That was Demo Burrows, the intended receiver, the junior out of Charlotte, North Carolina, and nearly picked off.
It seemed like Burrows didn't appear to believe that the ball was going to come, but the ball was also tipped, and so that helped the Spartans in their secondary almost have a takeaway.
JT Wahey, the junior, nearly picked that one off.
And again, good job by the Norfolk State defensive line. If you cannot get to the quarterback, get your hands up, and you see what happens. Good things.
Nick now has two wideouts, and he will keep it this time. First run for him, and did not fool anybody. The ball comes loose. The Spartans say they have it. And Nick losing yardage, though, I think they're going to say he was down by contact, and that will be a loss on the play by the leading rusher on this team for SC State, Nick.
Yes, and Deshaun Dixon comes in, and he's also from Chesapeake. A lot of guys, maybe they know each other, and just really corrals the quarterback, Nick, and also attempts to strip the ball. But the head linesman comes in and says, no, he was down.
Trips right-hand side now on a passing down at 3rd and 12. Deep in their own territory. Nick will buy some time, and now he is on his way with some speed of his own, getting back a lot of yardage on that one near the 28-yard line, and that will be still a fourth down coming up here for SC State.
Well, he's actually, we're going to give him the first down. See. Snuck inside.
Oh, he got it. Got him. That was close.
It was very close.
That was close.
Mark him at the 28.
Okay.
Give him a new set.
It really doesn't matter what I say. I'm not an official.
No, you don't get to spot the ball.
It's a nice run to keep this drive going by the sophomore. And now it will be James's turn. And this trying to find some room left-hand side. That has been much harder than the right. And James doesn't get much. It'll be second down and long.
Good pursuit by Norfolk State. The defense swarming, coming, you know, to the right and not giving much of an opportunity after the snap. It looked like there was something there, but Norfolk State closed quickly.
About a two-yard gain, so second down and 8 coming up. Clock runs, nearing 6 minutes to go. Shifting over there is James out of South Charleston, South Carolina. And now Nick again will be flushed out and stays on his feet, jumps around a little bit. Might have gotten a yard at the most. And here's another third down and long, something that the South Carolina State team really can't afford to do too much of. They're not, again, all that prolific through the air, and the majority of their weapons are the ones that can run.
Yes, and you don't want to live against the percentages all game long. And you're right. 3rd and 7, not necessarily the manageable distance.
Nick, last game at UCF on the 8th of September. 22 rushes, 78 yards. Had a 24-yard jaunt in that one. Trying to get some kind of impactful play here, this time through the air. High pass is caught at around the 37.
I think they need the 38. They're going to be a yard short.
That's DeMontrez Burrows with the reception. And he is bounced out of bounds there. The JT Wahey. That'll be a first down.
Oh, they give him the.
Yeah. See, we're both missing now.
Well, you had set the 37.
So. Four wideouts. Spreading it out here is Nick. And instead, he will keep it right. And he got a nice gain on the play up to the 44. Well, it looked like he was out around the 37, but nice spots here for SC State. And they'll take him here as they need a victory, though, 0-2. And this offense putting together one of their better drives, I think, probably for the season. 4 yards. Nice misdirection. Here's Nick again looking exclusively right, and then he is nearly brought down, and then finally is brought down from behind. And he felt that pressure, but he just couldn't get away from it. And that'll bring up a third down. Michael Quigar-Ata with the stop there.
That was a coverage sack because eyes were downfield, but no one was open.
Haverhill, Mass. And here we go. 4 minutes to go. I'm trying to sustain this drive. There's a loss on that play, so it's around third and nine coming up. Here's Nick now and has time, but here comes that edge rush. He's able to elude it, passes it, and I don't know if that was tipped or not, but that's still a lot as Nick did have time, but then you felt that edge rush come in and he had to get rid of the ball.
Well, and also had Nick just given the ball to his receiver in the flats quickly, he probably would have had a lot of running room as Jenkins, the running back, the redshirt sophomore, was available early.
Josh Bryant coming from behind and finally making the impactful hit was the one that came in and smacked him down. And so now SC State can't keep the drive going and will have to punt it away. Dylan Bredsoe doing the honors here. It'll be fielded at the 16-yard line. Sprinting right side.
And there's that man.
There's that run once again. That's right. Marcus Taylor. SC State wants to keep on going this game. They've got to keep it out of his hands. Look at this.
Oh, nice return. And nobody really challenging Taylor when he catches the ball. And just, you know, again, returns are arts, not sciences. And so once you get a feel for the open space and making defenders miss, you can get big chunks of yardage.
714 kickoff return yards. Obviously, that was a punt. Second most in school history. I mean, they're going to put the senior back there whenever they can on any kind of special teams return.
Good move.
Jawan Carter now. Back out. Will throw it left on some... A lot of misdirection, but SC State doesn't bite on any of it and makes a good play there in the defensive backfield, second down and long.
Chris Adams, number 33, stays home, and that's wisely done. As long as the ball doesn't cross the line of scrimmage, no need for you to leave where you're protecting on that defensive side of the ball. And he's a grad student, so he should know. He's been in the program for a while, and that was a better thought of defensive play than anything else.
Justin Smith with the reception, the redshirt sophomore. Now delay and a run up the middle. This is Savage getting him back to him, gets back to the original line of scrimmage. And in fact, actually, that is Gerald Hewlett, 6 foot, 190 pound redshirt junior, getting his first action of the evening.
And after some yardage lost on a kind of a throwback horizontal screen to the wide side, come back with a run, and South Carolina ready for it.
With these backs for Norfolk State, have some size on them at 210 and 190 there for Hewlett. Ranging right, nice lob pass down the right sideline, caught at the 25 and out of bounds. Ellington with the reception. SC State says it's not a catch, but the officials, I believe, disagree. And nice accuracy on the pass here on the run by Carter.
And South Carolina State kind of fell asleep in the secondary. And as you mentioned, Carter bought some time and a nice touch. Get some air under that pass towards the sideline. And Ellington hauls it in for a great game.
Kay Ellington, another sophomore getting a big play, run right. Coming in and making the stop there. SC State keeps that one from getting anywhere for Brent. And that's Cameron Brent. A lot of people seeing some action out of this backfield for Norfolk State, too.
Well, and we're also seeing
mixing it up.
Some receivers, different receivers for the Norfolk State Spartans also catch passes from Carter.
About a minute to go left here in the first quarter. And the Spartans with a second and nine. Their playbook seems a little bit more dynamic. Rolling left, wide open. And still enough for the first down, though, is that the 11s collide. And that's Winstead again. He had the lone, so far, touchdown in this game, and he makes another big play and moves the chains.
Gilchrist with a big hit. Way to hold on to the football, because the football definitely was the first thing to get hit with the arm, as you see Chad Gilchrist coming in, the redshirt sophomore, and cleaning it up.
Ball on the 14. So the Spartans can't get a first down without obviously getting into the end zone. Owner receiver far out, right-hand side is Ellington, but instead they're going to go left this time. And getting out of bounds and making a good play again. Getting out of bounds is Uwana.
You know, these 6'3 receivers, good targets.
Yeah.
You know, you hard to miss those guys. And what I like about Carter on this drive in particular is that, especially on those quick stop routes, 5 to 7 yards turn around, he's putting the ball on his receivers quickly.
They have three 6'3 receivers.
I like that.
And that's going to do it here for the first quarter of play here in MEAC action. We'll change sides here before Norfolk State and South Carolina State. We'll be back. You're watching MEAC football here on ESPN.
All backed by the unconditional satisfaction guarantee. Dickies Flex, engineered to move. Learn more at dickies.com.
Here at Orangeburg, South Carolina, home of the SC State Bulldogs, their first home game of the season, essentially, as their NC Central matchup on the 15th of September was postponed. So this is their first home game of the season. Norfolk State knocking on the door in their first away game, and they will hand it off up the middle to the Spartans and now get the chains moved. Brent with the run. And it will be the start of the second quarter, switching sides here. And Norfolk State getting out of the first quarter with no score given up. They've given up 24 points in the first quarter this season already. But after that, they've only given up six the entirety of the rest of the quarters they played in. So that was the one they wanted to get out of, and they had a 7-0 lead now.
Well, I tell you, you know, it seems like their lines of scrimmage are winning, at least to this point in the game.
Here's Winstead. Now, he had the reception for the score the last time down here for the offense, and he's maybe looking for more here in a third down, and a run to the right instead, And no mark yet for whether this is a touchdown. It's not. It's second down. That's what I thought. So first down and goal to go there on that last play. Now it's second down and goal to go from the one-yard line.
And Brenton follows the aforementioned Craig Rodwell, and he gets into the end zone, but Brent does not. They mark him just shy of the goal line, and second and goal with about 2.5 feet for Pater.
Rodwell here in the upper right side there, that right tackle slot. Brent stays in as your lone back under center. Carter back to Brent again, and the red wall comes up big. We'll see if they are able to stave off a score once again on this last play, and they do.
Chris Adams, number 33 for the South Carolina Bulldogs. Red, that run right from the snap and fills in right at the line. And low man wins pretty much every time in football. And so Adams getting underneath Brent and stopping
his momentum. Look at that. Look at how close that is.
Brent's not a small guy, you mentioned.
Oh, my goodness. You almost need to get a piece of paper out and see if it actually does touch it there. That's a great spot here. And a possibility of a keeper. Let's see for Carter. And he will do so, and he will get into the end zone, I believe. No indication here from the officials quite yet. There's a battle for the ball on the bottom of that. And it is a touchdown. That took a long time.
It did. What I really liked about that formation is that Carter came under center, not this shotgun snap when you're 6 inches away from the goal line, and it allows for the quarterback sneak, the traditional quarterback sneak, and Carter gets into the end zone. The whole scrum was in the end zone. I'm not sure why there was any kind of necessity to see what happened, because once the ball breaks the plane, it's a touchdown.
Here's the extra point attempt by Josh Nardone, and he will boot that through. And now Norfolk State all over SC State with a 14-0 lead on this plunge from Carter. He has two, one through the air and one on the ground. Welcome to timeout on the field, and we'll be back here with more MEAC football on ESPN.
Freak yeah!
Norfolk State getting the job done on offense and on a couple of back-to-back series, up leading 14-0 on the road against SC State. Bulldogs in desperate need for a win already at 0-2 on the year here at home for the first time on the season. D.E. Hansen along with Steve Foster here. Thanks for joining us here. MEAC action. And now SC State looks for a big return and good offensive start to this next series. Oh, my goodness. Coming up right side, and Nigel Chavis lays the wood.
6'2", 230, and he had a running start. Bang.
Right. 10-2 on special teams. There he is right there.
That was a big hit.
Sean Baines.
Did not like that.
No, he'll remember that for the rest. He's a freshman.
Well, and the aforementioned Chavis comes out and plays defensive line. He's the left end.
Here is Nick now, and they're going to try to find some room on the ground, the corners, the edges. Time it's Datron James, and he can't find anything. If we've seen anything work for SC State, it's still trying to run with Nick, but after he fakes the handoff on maybe some zone reads. But recently, in the last couple series here for Norfolk State, the Spartans seem to be settling into their defense.
Well, not a lot of imagination. No. So you're going to have to get Norfolk State going one way and use that tremendous momentum that they are getting with their upfield push against them.
Here's Nick again, and he kind of pump fakes a little bit. Now looks middle of the field, and it will be caught for a first down of 12 yards. So a little patience. And actually, he got some protection there, too, Will Vereen, with the reception.
Yes, and coming across the field, you know, I'm a big proponent of crossing routes, and it makes it easy to adjust to the ball, and you can run away from the defender.
Bobby Price making the play for Norfolk State. Now here's a nice sizable gain on a run. Right-hand side. Atron James with the run. So this offense being directed by a first-year offensive coordinator, at least for South Carolina State, and Bennett Swigert coming over from Newberry College the last five seasons and trying to make his impact here as well. Another handoff. Not a lot of selling on that one.
No, had James just gone one hole over, so between the guard and the tackle, he may have had a lot more running room. He kind of darted just straight up field. Sometimes you got to use a little bit of that lateral shake to free yourself up for more yardage.
Already a big down for SC State with the 1 yard to go for the first third down. And nice keeper by Nick. He read that one well, and he'll get the first at the 48.
Good tackle, though, coming up from Norfolk State. Looks like Bobby Price, number 7.
It's a couple of times he's made the play.
Not until the first down gain by
both times,
South you're Carolina right. State.
6'4", nice size there for DB. And now it's going to be an option keeper by Nick. Expected a lot more of that, and he refuses to go down until he gets into Norfolk State territory.
Good yardage on first down. And I think with a little more patience or allowing those linemen to get out in front, you could have had maybe a bigger gain by Nick.
Bobby Price making yet another play for the Spartans on defense. We'll change and look over, cycling through. You can see Nick there saying,
if you're going to audible
through again, please.
You're going to audible, come on.
Like a pitcher out on the mound asking his catcher to go through the plays again. Handoff goes left-hand side, and that's second and four. Won't yield much, and another chance here for the Spartans to either make a stop or, again, to make a nice play, I imagine, through the air here for SC State. And Nick has been a little bit more successful through the air in this game than he has in his prior two games.
He has, but you're going to have some patience, and I think you're going to have to help your quarterback out with the routes that you call for the receivers.
Port and down coming up with 9:02 left here in the first half of play. And with third and four staring the Bulldogs in the face, it's a big one already, down 14-0 here in the first half of play. Timeout on the field again. You're watching MEAC Football on ESPN.
It's sub. Wheat, yeah. Freak, yeah.
Big down coming up here for the Bulldogs. Down 14-0 as we're turned back to play here at Bulldog Stadium to Norfolk State. And the defense trying to stiffen up. 9 minutes left in the first half. And Nick through the air again. And it will be incomplete. Had a man open just a little bit behind him. And that will bring up a fourth down and four.
Wolverine came open on a nice post route underneath about 8 to 15 yards. But the pass just too high to be hauled in. That would have been a first down, D.
So we'll see as the punting unit comes out for the Bulldogs.
You don't want to miss too many of those because your receiver was,
he was very open. He was open.
Wide open.
Jerome Petaway, senior, to punt it away. And a fair catch indicated here at the around the 10-yard line. And that's exactly what I see from what you want to see out of Taylor, is that he does not return it back. And now Norfolk State with something to work with, all three timeouts and plenty of time as well here in the first half, up 14-0.
Unfortunate for South Carolina State. All three possessions in this game have resulted in the punts.
We've seen glimpses, though, from this SC State team. Again, that was struggling a lot on offense. And they've already put together some nice yardage on some drives, but again, these third downs, they have not been able to convert.
They have not, and it's unfortunate because there's been some opportunity.
On the other side, it's been a little bit the opposite. Norfolk State's offense has not been also all that prolific. But here this evening, they have been able to put some nice things together, mixing it up well, too, because we haven't just seen some nice runs. We've seen both medium and long-range pass plays go for gains for this Spartans offense. And it's nice to see how Juwan Carter has done.
Well, he's done very well. I mean,
so he has done really well, and so we'll look at Carter again. He's been a dynamic guy. He's keeping this offense together.
He sure is. And, again, we've already mentioned he's rushed for 178 yards in the first two contests, and if something's good, more's better.
So now it will be Carter again out of that shotgun. And he's been moving around a little bit, too, in some prescribed situations by the OC, and that time he finds Winstead, and he's been a very popular target here for Carter in this first half.
And it's interesting, we talk about the legs of Carter and he throws a pass to Winstead, but again, he's thrown well as to complement those rushing yards.
Deep in their own territory going for some quick pass plays.
Well, the Spartans could wind up being 2-1 after this contest if they stay ahead of South Carolina State.
Hewlett the back this time, as we've seen about three different backs for the Spartans, and instead they're going to go to Winstead again. And he'll be pretty close to a first down here as he looks like he inched his way to the 20-yard line.
And if not a first down, and we have not been on point with the officiating crew of what is and what isn't a first down, you still have a nice gain on second down and a manageable short yardage to go for a first down if this is not, in fact, a first down.
So he'll try to wrestle him down a little bit. It is a first down play. And you also saw, I think, Carter being able to freeze the defense a little bit just with that little show to Hewlett and then passing it to Winstead on that last play.
Brings up the run-pass option now for the quarterback, Carter, who can also, as we say, run well with the football.
Now we have movement. Not seen a lot of laundry here tonight, but this time we do. And of course, I should have said that. I understand. I just jinxed it.
Hey.
Procedure there against the Spartans. We'll bring it back.
I don't think they have this broadcast in their ear.
No, but in football's not nearly as worried about jinxing anything. It's,
right.
It's more of a baseball thing.
I think you're right. Or a basketball thing, you know.
Basketball,
it's made eight in a row.
And step on the
right.
Lines.
Exactly.
Kind of stuff. Okay, trips right this time and a first and 15. And that's Iwana in motion. Instead, it'll be a nice little gentle screen left-hand side over to Hewlett. He'll get up to the 25, 26 yard. No, they're going to mark it at the 24, it looks like. And that'll bring up a second down.
Good patient screen play there. And South Carolina State runs past the receiver. I think that's a good yardage given the fact that you mentioned a penalty moved the ball back to first and 15. Now just second and six.
Jablonski Green, the freshman, makes the stop. For
yes, he did.
I wanted to say that this evening. Here is Carter again. And press coverage here on Winstead as he will go to the flat, but instead it'll be a pass far to the top of your screen and a flag is thrown as well. That one completed to Taylor, but this should be coming back as well, possibly. Nope. Big, big play there. That's personal foul, hands to the face. SC State had been doing really well on defense, able to get that first initial penalty on a first and 15. Norfolk State just working the sidelines, but now they just give the Spartans that first down at the 43.
And a new set of downs, and the ball's getting to midfield, and a good offensive series.
Some of the interior defensive line here for SC State already with hands on hips. They've been out there for a while.
They have.
Carter now, again, another pump fake, looking right, then left this time, and lobs it deep down the left sideline, but it's well short, intended for Taylor. And really, red jerseys had the easiest chance on that one. Chris Adams making a dive for it.
Chris Adams has been around the ball, defending well, and this ball's just thrown a little short and a little bit to the middle of the field, and Adams was the only one that probably had an opportunity to make a catch. It would have been an interception, but I like the play action towards the middle of the field. Norfolk State not afraid to throw the ball downfield.
Opening it up after that penalty, especially now. Second and 10. And they will pass it again middle of the field. Near the logo.
Dangerous pass, but really good timing between Carter and Williams.
It was Williams, Anthony Williams, with his third reception of the year. That was a tough one to hold on to as he was well covered.
They could call that blanketed, but the dart thrown in there by Carter. Nice timing route there, and third and fairly manageable.
Big opportunity, though, for SC State's defense to try to get this ball back in the hands of the offense with around 5.5 to go. Third and 4. Passes tipped and nearly intercepted. So the defense does come up big, and it is Damu Ford with the tip at the line, which will bring up a fourth down.
And Ford, only 5'11", but again, wisely gets the hands into the passing lane and tips the ball up for an almost opportune time and an interception for South Carolina State, just barely falling harmlessly to the turf.
He showed some ups for 245.
And 5'11".
He was able to get up there. Well, that's why I'm saying he had to jump, and I was 245. I don't think I'd be able to get that high. Here is the punt now from Norfolk State. And that will be a coffin corner. Right inside the 5, so long way to go here for SC State. Offense on the field. Down 14-0 here at home to Norfolk State in MEAC action. You are watching MEAC football on ESPN.
Freakin'.
Big opportunity here for SC State, down 14-0 at home in MEAC play. Dee Hansen joined by Steve Foster here on ESPN. And it's 1st and 10 for the Bulldogs, down 14-0, as I said before. But the offense has moved here at times. Bend don't break defense continues for the Spartans, but now getting out of the shadow of their own area of their goal. A nice run up the middle here for SC State. Gets this offense going in the right direction.
And you got to have a little breathing room to let Nick operate here. And that's a good gain on first down.
Irish Nick, the quarterback, Gerald Manigault with that last run. And this next one, again, Manigault gets not much. And this Norfolk State defense, we kind of highlighted them a little bit too before this game started, is one of the best defenses by numbers in this very young season. The MEAC giving up just around 15 points per game and total yardage around 190. Total yards average given up.
Impressive.
That's very good.
That's impressive. Anything under 200 is ridiculous.
It's amazing they're 1-1.
Right.
Three receivers left-hand side here, but Nick will not look that way. And now it's another batted ball trying to hit Manigault in the flat. And another jump in hit out of the air, this time by Kyron Speller. He's 6'2", so you can see why he's able to climb the ladder and make the play.
And again, the linemen for both sides of the ball, South Carolina State and Norfolk State, they have been coached well. Get those hands up and bat the ball around.
6'2", 250, showing some athleticism there on the line. Another look over is SC State likes to get to the line, but then they will adjust the play. Here's Nick again, and modest pressure will have him be sacked behind the 10. Can't find any wiggle room there against Dale Craig, the junior linebacker. Now bring up a 3rd and long.
Rushed 5, and then when the pocket was collapsing, and there was coverage, Craig comes in from the linebacker position and cleans up the mess, and it's 3rd down and a lot.
Impressive defense here for the Spartans.
They play well as a unit.
They really do. Here's Nick again, and showing there on the edge in the bottom of your screen, Nigel Chavis, and he has had a good game too here for Norfolk State. And now Nick on a big 3rd down. Deep in his own territory, we brought down. The ball comes loose, but he'll be down by contact at around his own 1. And again, it's Craig coming in.
Well, that was a stunt, a blitz from that 2nd level, the linebacker level, and Craig just comes through untouched effectively. And that nice little delay was not accounted for. No one blocks you. You can have a free run at the quarterback.
Got a good run to start out that offensive series, and then went backward ever since that point.
I think when you said good move, Norfolk State challenged you on that.
Jerome Pettaway, and watch out. Don't forget who's back here in Taylor. He gets 1 bounce, and he'll work with this. Goes backwards instead near midfield, and still goes backwards, and he's in trouble. Great coverage downfield by the Bulldogs, and it will be the Spartans in their own territory when they fielded it in SC State territory instead.
Bruce Johnson.
So now it will be Norfolk State with the ball and the lead. You're watching MEAC football here on ESPN.
From your game face to your game day rituals, everything you do matters.
No pressure.
You know, SC State has had their moments on offense, but the defense has actually played pretty well considering the circumstances coming into this game against Norfolk State here in Orangeburg, South Carolina. I'll get to that point here in a second after this play here, but as the Spartans take over, 1st and 10, their own territory with a run left-hand side, and now back into Bulldog territory, and that run by Savage, who is the starting running back, at least for this game, but we've seen a host of backs here for Norfolk State getting some play. And SC State came into this game giving up over 37 points per game on the year. Right now they're playing pretty well. The offense just can't get going. Another run here as Norfolk State, it will go to Savage and see if he can power this offense down the field for yet another score. And already at the 40. Now that sets up the play action with a lob left hand side. One-handed catch! And a flag comes in at the 20. That's Winstead again. We'll see if this stands.
I think this is going to be offensive pass interference, believe it or not. And I think Winstead's going to have to come out of the game because the helmet came off. It was a heck of a move, but I think this is going to come back.
My goodness. That's one of the best offensive pass interference catches I've ever seen.
Well, that's true, but it's a penalty. And you can't hold off the defender. I like it.
Oh,
I'm an offensive guy.
Really? Really? That was questionable.
No, that was...
Great play.
That was
great play by Winston.
That was clear as clear can be. Unfortunately, I love the competitiveness downfield that the receiver had, but you can't hold off a defender that openly and not have a hanky fall.
Two receivers right here, and they're going to be out of the shotgun again and try to clear the conscience there of Winstead, who was clearly happy with the reception. And he won't be in this play as he, again, like you said, Foss lost his helmet. Well, added protection on your right-hand side, and then the handoff. Huge hole up the middle. We'll get a nice game by Savage again into Bulldog territory.
And both teams have all of their timeouts, so you can still go with the hurry-up offense, but you still have three timeouts in the back pocket.
Clock runs, getting close to a minute to go here, and it was a first and a mile. Now it's second and 16. They're going to get a lot of that back from Winstead again as he's quickly back in, and he has been the bell cow for this offense. We'll see if there's a timeout taken here by the Spartans.
Timeouts are never in the front pocket. Why aren't the timeouts in the front pocket?
I don't know.
They always keep them in the back.
They don't need them right now, apparently. And then flushed out. And then throwing on the run. Anyway, picked off at the 5. What a huge play. Jumping in front of that one was Quincy Hill. And the freshman will get the ball back in SC State's hands.
That was a quarterback who got a little greedy because Carter could have tucked that ball and run. There was an opportunity out in the flat, but feeling it going downfield, and a great break on the ball, as you mentioned, by the freshman, and a turnover created by South Carolina State deep in their territory, and they needed that because if they go down 21-0, could be tough coming back from three touchdowns.
Usually it's Norfolk State doing the turning the ball over, forcing them by their defense, and this time SC State. It's a much-needed one. Now still deep in their own territory, but that is at least something to work on, even if SC State doesn't get a score here going into the locker room. In fact, they're actually going to kneel on it and wind this clock down for the first half, down 14-0.
What you could do is call three timeouts if you're going to take three knees. Conceptually, for Norfolk State, and make the punt happen, you got a guy like Taylor bring the ball all the way back and then try a field goal. Now, maybe you don't need to get that greedy up 14, and maybe these two coaches know each other, but to me, could have been a valid strategy.
Absolutely. SC State will get the ball to start out the second half because they deferred to start out the game, and that'll be it for this first half of play. Big turnover to end the first half, a much-needed one, a little glimmer of hope here for the Bulldogs, as they will now go into the locker room. Down 14-0 at home, but something to work with going into the second half of play. We'll be right back once again here from Bulldog Stadium in Orangeburg, South Carolina. You're watching MEAC Football here on ESPN.
Yeah. That's Charles would do it like this. Make it an ass.
Back here at Bulldog Stadium, where Norfolk State, the Spartans, have marched in here in MEAC action against the SC State Bulldogs here in Orangeburg, South Carolina, and have a 14-0 lead. The SC State able to get a interception going into halftime, looking for something in the second half of play. This is a MEAC Football on ESPN.
Under these lights,
a whiteout night in Happy Valley.
Anything can happen on Saturday night.
Back at Bulldog Stadium again here where the Norfolk State Spartans have a 14-0 lead on the road in MEAC play against SC State. The Bulldogs will have the football to start out the second half of play, and we'll look to that last-second interception to end the first half of play to get them going in that second half. This is MEAC Football on ESPN.
Complex, but understanding your mortgage is simple. Get approved in as few as 8 minutes with Rocket Mortgage by Quicken Loans, America's largest mortgage lender.
Get it? Thanks. Okay, back here at Bulldog Stadium, Dee Hansen and Steve Foster. Here's some highlights of the first half here.
We see a lot of running up the middle, and we talked about that at the beginning, and a pass for a touchdown as well from Carter. A run pass option there to get Norfolk State on the board. Again, Carter up the middle and using his legs to get in the end zone. 14-0. But the South Carolina State defensive attack keeping any other additional points off the board. But both of these defensive lines playing well, getting their hands up when necessary. One turnover there for Norfolk State, and it's 14-0. And South Carolina State, the Bulldogs at home, still with an opportunity to win this game.
Norfolk State on the season had been outscored 24-10, and they've already scored more points in the first half than they have all season long in the first two games of the year. So that's good for the Spartans' offense, but their defense, we already knew, was playing well. SC State's defense playing pretty well in this first half. So now it's really up to the Bulldogs' offense to get things going here in the second half of play.
It absolutely is, and they've only scored 6 points during that 0-for-2 unfortunate situation, as their first two games have been against quality opponents, Georgia Southern and UCF, and only 6 points to be tallied. So they got to get on the scoreboard to make this work.
Talking about Tyree Snick, the quarterback for the NC State Bulldogs. Boy, he had a hard time getting things going, not in the beginning, but towards the end. That's when the Spartans defense really tightened up.
Well, they have, and as we've discussed, and now y'all would know, this defense of the Spartans, less than 200 total yards in a game. That's so impressive.
Yeah, and although we were talking about the defense for SC State here a little bit, it had been horrible going into this game. Giving up almost 36 points per game, but only 14 here in the first half. So they're giving that offense something to work with.
They sure are. But again, that offense needs to get off only scoring 6 points in these first two games. They're going to have to at least double that output to win today.
Now, it will be SC State. They did defer on the coin toss, so they will be getting the ball in the second half.
Yes.
Getting that pick gives them something to work with also to talk about in the locker room, and we'll see if they're able to do that, get something going on the ground and through the air. You're watching MEAC Football here on ESPN.
Whatever you do, don't forget that the more you live forward, the more you need someone at your back. The powerful backing of American Express. Don't live life without it.
Hey, we're glad you're back here in Orangeburg, South Carolina. It's time to bring you out onto the field for the pride of South Carolina State. It's the Marching 101. Under the direction of new band director Patrick Reed. See Rice do this.
Make some noise for your favorite
Except Rice. Back here once again to Bulldog Stadium, Dee Hansen, joined by Steve Foster here on ESPN's coverage of the MEAC Conference as the Norfolk State Spartans looking for a very difficult win, as it always usually is on the road here against SC State and the Bulldogs. Steve, you look at this game now where Norfolk State has scored more points than they have all year in the first half with 14. They only came in with 10 in the first half prior to that. And now they take on a struggling SC State squad that has to feel good about things still. I mean, the offense couldn't get anything going, but the defense looks much improved after their first two games of the season. So now you get the football to start out this third quarter of play, and you got an interception to stave off any kind of drive that the Spartans had late in the second quarter.
Correct. The only thing that I would look at and say has to be improved from what you said was the ability to score on South Carolina State's part. They've done great on defense to keep a team to 14, regardless of what that team's done prior to coming in to Orangeburg, South Carolina, but they've got to get on the scoreboard.
And there you see the veteran coach here for South Carolina State, an alum from 1975. There's Buddy Poe in his 17th season as the head coach, has 120 wins to get 66 losses. In the MEAC, he's an incredible 94-33, and this will be his last season as the head coach at SC State, calling it, or at least retiring here at the end of the season.
Well, he wants to go out, you know, doing very well, and this team last season wasn't
where you'd like it to be
successful at all, unfortunately, with the 3-7 record. But there's a lot of quality players. You know, they get a second round draft pick, Darius Leonard, that goes out of this program. And so it's a program that can do well. It just has to convert and not come up just short. And that's going to be this season by scoring some points because, as mentioned, the defense looks good.
Well, they've done really well under his tutelage up until the last couple of years. I mean,
correct.
He's 10-3 against this Norfolk State school. And on top of that, they lost their first game ever to NSU last year in a 13-10 loss. Excuse me, 2 years ago in 2016, to have a 9-1 record against this team in recent years. So this is SC State not in its best form the last couple seasons, and I think you're right. I think he might feel like he's going to try his obviously his best here this particular year, try to get this team going again. He has a sophomore quarterback, so he's not leaving the cupboard completely bare at all in Tyrese Nick, who has looked good at moments. And in talking about Poe, this offense also has been up and down just in this game, though, but at least they're showing signs. And yes, the Spartans defense has shown up in many occasions during this game, but let's be honest, also SC State has had moments where they just didn't convert on what should have been an easy pass play or run if they'd read it correctly.
Yes, there was at least a couple of instances where converting on third down would have really given the Bulldogs an opportunity to score. And unfortunately, you see four possessions, four punts, and then the half concludes after an interception. The takeaway is great, but the points must come for the Bulldogs.
Sophomore place kicker to the honors here, Nardone, to kick it off for Norfolk State, as SC State had won the coin toss and elected to defer, so now they have it to start out this third quarter of play. A very short kick and a little confusion there on the return, but finally figured out and brought to the 29-yard line. Good starting field position here for the Bulldogs, and a little pushing and shoving at the end of that particular play as Manigault brings it back.
Yes, and sometimes the return men have to be like outfielders. You have to say, I got it, and the other has to be the personal protector so that you can get a block from the first defender coming down covering a kick or a punt, and right there a little mix-up, but still getting the ball to the 30-yard line.
Sophomore trots out there, and Nick now out of the shot, going to start out the first offensive series of this second half, and he will complete that ball to the right-hand side over to DeMontez Burrows. And nothing better than get that first pass out of the way, also to establish some sort of level of momentum as well.
And Nick may need to use his legs, almost rushing for 90 yards in the first two contests apiece. And so if he can do that, he can keep this Norfolk State defense at bay.
Here's James now with the carry, and he'll get past the 40 to the 42. And SC State already looks like they're mixing it up, and that offensive line getting some room there for James to run through.
I tell you, the ball getting closer to midfield, but the return set this up, D, for the second half.
Second down, and a little play action throw right-hand side, and nice catch again by Burrows. He's the go-to guy so far for Nick to start out this third quarter.
I've always thought the passes less than 15 yards, especially on timing, should be easy to convert.
Seen both these offense kind of work that way. Long look down the right side of the field this time, and it will be incomplete, but a flag is thrown as both the offender and defender working on each other. That was, of course, intended for Burrows, and defending on that one. Down the field, we'll see what the flag is all about first.
The junior, number four.
So again, you get JT Wahi, who has made a couple of good plays in this game, but you can see the hold there and keeping that right arm from getting up.
I think that may have been a little frustration because Burrows with two receptions here quickly in this second half, and so you don't want a third one down the field. So as the defender, you say, let me see if I can get away with something.
A little motion here, and SC State has something working. Another play action and then throw out to the flat right-hand side, and still getting positive yardage down the field, and the Bulldogs continue to do so and mixing things up with the run and the pass, that time getting it to Cornelius Govan, the freshman.
And I like the action because Govan went from left to right, and he snuck underneath behind the line to get open.
And now this time, the run doesn't go anywhere. James tries to find the edge left-hand side and gets blasted.
Linebacker Givers Wilson comes through and just, he was not fooled at all. He was in the backfield right after the handoff and drops the rusher.
Burrows in the bottom of the screen. Nick with some hard counts there. Everybody moves, no flags. Pass is incomplete, almost intercepted, though, by Aaron Chandler. And he's calling for a flag, and he won't get it. It'll bring up a fourth down and nine.
And Burrows did a good job to beat defender and smacks the ball out of the defender's hands, as we mentioned, and goes harmlessly to the turf. But a great job by the receiver to become the defender, because that could have been a turnover.
And now we'll see what the Bulldogs do here. Little waiting game. Finally, we'll have the shift from the offense to the special teams. And Taylor to go back to receive here for Norfolk State, although it'd be hard-pressed to see whether he even gets a chance on this one. Here's the punt. And it will go out the back into the end zone. No shot at that one. And now Norfolk State will come out on offense. But that was a promising start for the Bulldogs in that offensive series. And as it has been all game long, they have not been able to put a whole drive together.
They have not. And that has, I think, the rationale of why you don't see a lot of points even into this third game for South Carolina State. It's the inconsistency of this offense. Even though it makes good plays, it doesn't connect the plays together to sustain a drive and have even a chance for a field goal.
How big that run that really didn't end up being much there for James to the left-hand side where he lost about 5 yards ended up being. Now first offensive series for Norfolk State will be a run. And a little delay on that carry by Savage. And he doesn't get much. This Bulldog defense trying to keep this team in it. Down 14-0 in the third quarter.
Audrey Perry coming in from his defensive lineman, the redshirt junior, and he puts a hurting on the ball carrier for Norfolk State and also does a great
Savage
job.
Yep. This offensive line for Norfolk State had really been doing a good job a lot of that first half, but it seems like the Bulldogs are getting off the line a little bit easier now. Here comes some pressure on the backside, and a floated pass right is just overthrown by Carter. And that'll bring up a third down.
That's the way you want to do it. Put some air under the ball and let your receiver run under it. But Williams isn't as fleet of foot as Winstead or the other receivers that you have for the Spartans wanna. And I like the call, I like the pass, but you have to have somebody that can convert.
And that's your tight end. Right. Imagine that.
That's right.
Williams is 6'3". Right. But you're trying to get, you're saying that your tight end should get underneath that faster. It was a nice play all around. He was definitely open. NC State only looking like they're going to send three, but then they send a lot more. Flush out of the pocket is Carter. On the run, he throws it, and it's complete. It is complete to Winstead. Of course it is. On the far side sideline from us, and that should be a first down.
Winstead does well to help the quarterback just free himself on along the sidelines and make himself a target, and he does, and I think he picks up the first down.
Winstead started the scoring in this game with a 3-yard touchdown pass from Carter, made it 7-0 with 8:20 left, and then a 1-yard touchdown plunge by Carter, making it 14-0. But Winstead has been the star of this game on the offensive side of the football for either school. Now here's Carter on a first down and great conversion. And he'll keep it, sprints right, almost tripped up, stays on his feet, and with that able to gain about a yard.
Defensive pressure by South Carolina State to try to disrupt the action and the activity of the motion man coming to us in Taylor, but nobody fooled in the red jerseys.
Now Carter's not quite the runner that Nick is, but he doesn't have to be. You can see that he has Savage, Hewlett. We see Brent in this game run it for Norfolk State. And he has some receivers to go to as well. So this offense a little bit more dynamic. But he has run the football with a little bit of success this season. That's the seventh rush of the year. First, second down. And here's the little float pass caught for a first down and a lot more near midfield. And when you can get your running backs in space like Carter just did for Savage on that throw, then you've got a lot of things going on for your offense.
It's a classic screen pass, and you get your offensive lineman out in front, and that's my favorite pass to catch actually as a running back. And it's because you get your line on the move, and so much of the defensive rush is at the quarterback, and they realize once he dumps the ball to that running back, they've given up position.
Spartans not wasting any time now. The play action looking deep, and instead he gets it batted from behind, and the ball is loose. What are the officials going to say here? Because that was a fumble, and SC State recovers and gets the big-time turnover.
Xavier Johnson, number 99, redshirt freshman. It's all in the backfield. It almost looked like he knew what the play was, D. And wisely dislodges the ball.
Big course of events here. The defense coming up big for the Bulldogs once again. We'll be on offense to start out this next series. You're watching MEAC Football on ESPN.
It doesn't have to make sense.
Norfolk State giving up the ball once again. Their second turnover of the game. SC State forcing two. And now it will be SC State with the football down by 14, but already in Spartan territory. And back to pass is Tyrese Nick. He is on the move now, and he will have to tuck it in and get to the 35. Not bad.
No, get something out of nothing because it was a jailbreak up the middle. The defense for Norfolk State all in the backfield of South Carolina State. Nothing for the quarterback to do except try to escape somewhere and pick up some positive yards, and that's what happened.
He gets 6 yards, in fact, and actually to make it 5 inside the 35. And Nick again will hand it off up the middle in one of the better runs we've seen recently, at least. That from Datron James.
Was it for Givers Wilson?
Nice. Yep.
That play could have broke for a lot more. I think the first down, though.
It's a first down, more importantly, and Bulldogs wasting no time here. And another, this time a play action throw right. That is caught, and again, we've seen this iteration before, this offense being able to pull 3 or 4 plays together and look good. It's Quan Caldrell, the receiver, to get the Well, the team's moving again, or second down, but
playing well between the 20s, but that's not going to get you a score.
Here's Nick again. He wisely keeps it on the read, gets to the 20. Brought down at the 16, but a first down run.
Good job there, as you mentioned. The decision is what makes this play go. The keeper by Nick, and then a cut inside. And good yardage there again.
Nice block upfield, too, by Cornelius Walker. Low snap. Here's Nick looking right. Goes to the end zone. It'll be intercepted. Bringing it out. Left sideline. Still dancing. And then gets crushed. Right around the 24 is Navre Quinnerly. And that will be the first turnover of the game for South Carolina State. And a late flag coming in could add more yardage to this return.
Not exactly sure if it's a block on the return to help the interceptor get back upfield. We'll wait for the referee.
Quinterly, redshirt junior with the pick. Oh. And he's been ejected. That is a big one. Nigel Chavis, who has had a very good game, is going to be called for targeting, and he has been ejected from the game.
Yes, and that's surprising because, again, you're just trying to create an opportunity, and I see the hit to the right, but it didn't look like it was going.
Yeah, it wasn't on what we just saw there. It was off to the side a little bit. And that's huge. There he goes.
And I know he's not happy about that because it looked like a good block.
That is the second interception of the year thrown by Nick. And most importantly, though, here for the Spartans, they extinguished what is one of the more promising drives for the Bulldogs in this game so far. And trying to get a little bit of breathing room at their own around 7-yard line, and it will be a loss of one on the play there on the run by Savage.
And back to that last play or on the interception, coming back upfield, it looked like you had a blindside hit, and when the blindside hit occurred, and we can see it here, you can see in the replay, and it's not where the interception and the tackle was. It was just beyond that. It was an opportunity to make a hit.
And
here's second and 12 after the loss of two on that run, and out the right hand side, caught by Williams. Will definitely give a little bit more space to this offense to work with, and including getting very close to a first down.
Good play selection there, getting the ball out on the sidelines quickly.
Just when you think the Bulldogs have something going, that defense again for Norfolk State coming up big. And in fact, they were plus two coming into this game, so they were a zero in that ratio,
right?
Something they led in the conference last year, plus 15, and now they're back at plus one. Big third and three coming up for the Bulldog defense. Taylor in motion. Savage quickly down to Williams again. He'll get the first down and more eluding tacklers. Right side and then ankle tackled around the 35.
Yes, and that's what a big target can do, break tackles. And a nice pitch and catch right in the middle of the field. Very safe pass and very completable pass. And then after that, Williams rumbling after he breaks the tackle.
Jaden Brunson with the stop. The defensive back, the freshman, making the play for the Bulldogs. First down. It's hard to key on anything with this Norfolk State offense as they are pretty dynamic. Another play action and then a quick slant is incomplete.
I like the design of the play there. Carter throws a ball a little low to Taylor. However, if you can thread the needle on that and Taylor gets that, that's a foot race.
It's pretty good coverage there, too, and he's in the front end of that.
So he just throws the ball, waits a little long, and the release point is low, D, and so the ball goes low. That's just going to be a physics problem you can't overcome.
Brunson on the back end of that covering on Taylor for SC State. Second and 10. And it will be a handoff right inside. This is Hewlett with the carry, and just when NC State gets a good stop, they give up a big run in this particular instance. But still, third down.
Manageable three.
Manageable three here for the Spartans.
I like the weaving that the running back showed, because that was patience. And you have a third down and manageable. And I think Norfolk State, with the abilities that they've had to give you a run-pass option, you have to play base defense if you're South Carolina State.
Right side of that offensive line, Rodwell again making some plays there, blocking up front. Highlighted him before. And now it will be a rollout right, and it will be caught by Taylor for a first down. Not much there, but you move the chains.
Yes, and you get the action, and you make the defense think, run inside. It gives Taylor an opportunity to get past the sticks, and then a nice pitch and catch.
Taylor keeping both feet in.
He probably has aspirations to continue to play.
Apparently. That would do it. This clock running.
Yeah, 5:06 here in the third, D. Hanson, Orangeburg, South Carolina.
So that is a first down again, and Norfolk State really draining this clock. Defense comes up with some pressure, but it will be Carter eluding it, and then again making something out of nothing. Carter didn't come in as this big-time rusher, but he has shown the ability, when he has to make a play on it with his legs.
I like the word escapability, because you're right. It's not going to be like Nick, where he's going to take off and go for, you know, 60, 70, 90 yards total on the ground, but he can keep his team in manageable downs so that the chains can keep moving.
Norfolk State, SC State, not planning to play this year, but based on Hurricane Florence throwing a big monkey wrench in the schedule, they are here in a non-conference game. And now you have Brent trying to find room to the right side. And that had been working really well for Norfolk State. If you remember, this whole drive has been predominantly in the top of your screen. This time, SC State does a good job of keeping that from going anywhere.
Yes, and a good play coming up from the second level is linebacker Ford, the redshirt senior.
Calvin Giles McCleary also in that group for the red-clad Bulldogs. Third down, another opportunity. SC State trying to keep in this game, down 14 to nothing. Here's another maneuver that you have usually convert, but this time the soft pass falls off the hands of Savage. He's wide open in that zone. And a fourth down coming up, and the Bulldog defense coming up like they have for the majority of this game.
The defense, they actually dodged the bullet there, because Carter extends the play and finds a receiver that's open beyond the first down marker.
Just behind the receiver, and lots of green. Here comes the punt.
Very catchable.
Very catchable. Taylor Getty to punt from his own 36. Just under 3.5 to go in this third quarter. Bulldogs running out of time. High kick, beautiful kick, but it goes out the back into the end zone. Just too much on that one. Here's a flag on the play. Personal foul, roughing the kicker. Oh my, and that will be a first down. And just coming in on that leg, just enough.
That kind of looks like running into the kicker. Yeah. But again, we don't make the calls.
We don't.
Just report on them.
And we don't editorialize, apparently, either. First and 10 coming up here for the Spartans again. As the Bulldogs had done a good job being able to get a punt forced, and not only do you get a first down, but now you're starting at the 34-yard line of your opponent. And here's Carter again. And Savage behind him, he'll get the call, and waited for blockers to make make a hole, and there wasn't anything there.
There was no blocking. There was all tackling, and there was very few white shirts or jerseys around. It was all South Carolina.
A lot of red. That's right. So now that will bring up another second and long, which we've seen a couple of instances now against the Spartans. They've had the ball seemingly
all quarter.
All quarter.
And they have those 6-3 receivers we mentioned earlier.
Love to see that time of possession as the Spartans have had for the majority of the game. And Winstead has been a guy that's got him out of a lot of trouble in this game. We'll see if they go to him and running to the left-hand side, just having to get rid of that football, is Carter. And that Bulldog defense, I'm telling you, is coming up big. No time to look at Winstead that time, or anybody else for that matter.
Well, there is somebody trying to just run to just not get tackled, and right there, a lot of pursuit, as you mentioned, from the red jerseys.
Cordell Brown, redshirt senior defensive end, coming in and forcing that incomplete. Brings up a third and 13.
Carter just trying to get the ball out of his hands.
So
defense barreling down.
Spartans are going backwards. 37 of SC State. And SC State only showing four right now. And a timeout taken on the field here by the Bulldogs. An important third down and 13 coming up for both schools, as Norfolk State has that lead 14-0, but the Bulldogs pressing. They're watching MEAC football right here on ESPN.
I'm pretty smart.
Don't let that go to your head, Gary.
What's in your wallet?
This SEC defense has looked really good so far throughout the majority of this game, SC State. But now they find themselves having a chance, another opportunity to force a punt after a tough 15-yard penalty on a punt by Norfolk State. But if Carter has anything to say about it, he'll try to right now with a throw left-hand side. It is caught. No, incomplete at the 27. And that was over to Taylor. And I guess he just couldn't hold on to it on the near side sideline. We'll see right here.
Alex Brown, number 30. Richard Sr. breaks on.
It's hard
Taylor.
To tell. Yeah, but
he stripped him.
That's a stripped him. That's right. Great play. Right on top of it. And another punt for the Spartans in that SC State defense. My goodness. I mean, I'm serious. They forced two turnovers in this game. It looked like the Spartans were off to a rip-roaring start at 14-0, but it's been held there. Here's the punt. Getty keeps it inbounds. This started in the field of play before going back into the end zone, but special teams just can't keep it in. And Bulldogs offense has got to get something going.
They have to. The defense, as mentioned, valiant to keep Norfolk State off the board here as they go out and they score seemingly on their first quarter drives. The second touchdown for the Spartans happened after the first quarter ends. Second quarter resumes. They score on that drive that started in the first quarter. So after that, no scoring by either team. However, South Carolina State, as you mentioned, D, has had some opportunities and glimmers, but they just cannot complete and convert on the drives.
Here's Nick out of the shotgun, and we have movement, and apparently on both sides, it will have a procedure against the Bulldogs. Not how they want to start out this series. Yeah, we have to go back to 12:40 left in the second quarter, when Carter went in from 1 yard out for the rushing score. Since then, nothing. In fact, we've had three turnovers
right
since that time.
The defenses, as you said, have been playing masterfully.
That's right. Here's a keeper by Nick, right side. Gets good blocking and wisely decides to keep it down the or towards the sideline, and then a flag is thrown. And this could wipe out the run of a holding call against the Bulldogs.
And that's a wide receiver just trying to help a quarterback out.
And Nick had enough hesitation on that run to maybe cause it, because the wide receiver wasn't exactly sure if he was going to break it back in or out.
Right.
And sometimes you can screw up the blocking a little bit when you, but I mean, you have to do what you instinctually you need to do.
That's right.
So I'm not blaming Nick. I'm just saying that's sometimes you get caught up like that.
Well, so you'd like to set your blocker up in the right way as opposed to a questionable in or out cut. And right there, unfortunately, South Carolina State pays for that.
First and 20 now. After a nice run by Nick, and this time he'll keep it again. Go up the middle, and they get driven back. And that Spartan defense, Dale Craig, he's been looking good too.
225-pound junior is having no more of Nick running. And a good form tackle. Didn't get his, you know, lead with his helmet in his head. Got up into the body of the rusher and drove him backwards.
Second and 11 now after the short gain. Lob down the right sideline. It's caught at the 45 and going into the end zone. Touchdown, Bulldogs. DeMontrez Burroughs with the score. And SC State desperately needed that.
Unbelievable pitch and catch. And the run after the catch to run away from the secondary. Also impressive by the junior, but football right on the money and just over the outstretched hands of a defender that had an interception in the end zone. And that play could hopefully spark this South Carolina State Bulldog crowd and team to get back into this contest, D.
First passing score of the year for Nick. And it couldn't come at a better time than just that time. 7 points on the board for South Carolina State. They've already exceeded their average of scoring with that seven on the board now. My goodness. Bulldog defense can't wait to get back out there too. Now we have a skirmish going on. A flag on the field based on that.
Now come on, man. It's just an extra point. But that's one of those explosive plays, you know, more than 20 yards.
Here we go. See what this is all about. After the play. Oh, my goodness. So the Spartans again. Unsportsmanlike conduct. And Norfolk State now, their lead trimmed to 7 after that big play to Burroughs. You're watching MEAC Football right here on ESPN. Coming into this game, Tyrese Nick, the quarterback for the South Carolina State offense, had a total of 68 yards in 2 games. He just eclipsed that in 1 play of 70-plus yards to Burroughs. DeMontrez Burroughs with the score makes it 14-7. And we had an unsportsmanlike conduct penalty as well on that one. And now it will be a kickoff from midfield for the Bulldogs within a touchdown. And that kickoff out the... just shy of the back end of the end zone will stay in play. But 105 left here in the third quarter. And the Spartans, although leading 14-7, clearly don't have the momentum in this game. In fact, the Bulldogs' defense, I think, has had momentum on their side all the way maybe toward the back end of the second quarter and all throughout this third quarter.
I'd have to agree. Finally, though, breaking the ice and getting on the scoreboard should work wonders for this Bulldogs team.
So it's amazing what one play could do. Let's see if that will continue to empower this defense for SC State against Norfolk State. And here's a show and then a run and a throw down the right sideline. Incomplete. That pass intended for Marcus Taylor and broken up smartly. Coming in was Chris Adams. And that will bring up a second down now. And Spartans really have done a good job of mixing things up on offense with some misdirection and runs and passes and everything else. So as far as creativity goes, Norfolk State's doing the job, but SC State's not biting.
No, they're not. And Chris Adams has made several good plays, the grad student.
And that'll be a second down now coming up from their own 24 here for Carter and company. And a handoff goes nowhere. A loss of one on the play.
You could feel that hit.
My goodness.
South Carolina State knew exactly what was going on.
Oof.
When you have a running start from Cordell Brown, 6'2", 260. He looks bigger than that, though. And upends the running back in the backfield. And it's going to be third and long.
Third and about 11 to go here. Let's see. But Norfolk State will dial up as this Bulldog defense stiffens. Only three coming. Pass is incomplete. Triple coverage out to the left. And that intended for Anthony Williams as he was blanketed by Red. And that'll bring up a fourth down.
Alex Brown gets his hand in there and knocks this ball away. Number 30. Good job.
Well, tale two halves continues. And SC State has wanted it to be the second half of play. But Norfolk State had given up 6 points in the second half total this season. And SC State has gotten on the board for one more. Nice punt from Getty. And it'll be fair caught at the 38-yard line by DeMarcus Doe, freshman. A lot of freshmen finding their way into this ballgame also for the Bulldogs.
Great job by the punt returner not to let the ball bounce and hit. That's that hidden yardage that you do not want to have your offense losing 12 yards because a return man lets the ball bounce on the turf.
2 seconds before we conclude the third quarter of play. And this one owned by the Bulldogs as they were able to force a turnover, keep a turnover from going anywhere, keep a personal foul on a punt where the Spartans offense started deep into SC State territory. And now the offense getting into gear. Nick, pitch right. Finding room, good blocking up front. And a first down run on that near side sideline will conclude the third quarter. SC State will change sides. We'll have a chance to even things up on this next offensive series. Come on back. You're watching MEAC Football right here on ESPN.
For the win to make any tailgate one for the record books. Zaxby's, the official chicken of sports fans.
Just getting underway here with the fourth quarter from Orangeburg, South Carolina at Bulldog Stadium, where the SC State Bulldogs are fighting back into this one, down 14-7 at home to Norfolk State and the Spartans. Here's a run right-hand side on a second and short. Start out this fourth quarter, and that is Nick with the keeper. Not bad, Steve, for a game that wasn't even supposed to be played between these two schools. It wasn't on the schedule. They are obviously conference opponents, but this is a non-conference game. All kinds of things happen when you have weather play a factor, and that's what's happening in this matchup now. But SC State, that defense is rounding into form right in front of our eyes. Here's a pitch left, and another sizable gain on the ground this time for the Bulldogs, and that out to Dejarius Jenkins, the redshirt sophomore running back.
A couple folks down. I think one for each team. Unfortunate there. Not sure exactly.
It's Kyron Speller that we saw on the ground face down. And he is a big component, that defense for Norfolk State. And a player obviously down, left-hand side here. And having a hard time getting onto his feet, putting any pressure on that left leg.
Tight end, Austin Roger, or Rugger.
So here's the play, and you can see both the player getting kind of stood up there as Rugger. And quickly back to action. Speller looked fine as he was able to get back on his feet and get off the field without any assistance. I don't think Rugger got as fortunate. First and 10 nonetheless on that last play to keeper Nick. He will be tracked down from behind but stays on his feet. And inbounds, out of bounds at the 21.
Number six, Skeeter Watkins. Wilson trying to come from the backside to chase down Nick, but Nick keeping those legs churning, the high knees. And
he felt them a little bit, I have a feeling.
Stepped out of the tackle.
At those ankles. And now it will be a handoff up the middle.
Good design.
Finding some good carries here up the middle. Jenkins again, and he hadn't really played all that much of this game. Now he is.
Like the blocking scheme here at the point of attack. Don't go straight at that defense that has been gobbling you up.
Here's Nick with the keeper. Inside to the five. He loses the football at the two, and I believe the Spartans get on top of it. Oh, my goodness. Norfolk State with a big turnover, a much-needed one. For them, at least. And now we'll see how this play comes out. Did that knee come down yet? Nope, flipping around. That ball's out.
Same.
And recovered by Bobby Price.
But, it was number 22, as you mentioned earlier, with the interception. Quinterly dislodging the ball. Such a promising drive, D, for South Carolina State. And that was inside the five.
Two turnovers apiece for these two schools now, but horrible timing. There's still plenty of time. Norfolk State now deep in their own territory. Here is Juwan Carter. He'll throw right out of the gate, right inside. It is caught. Still on his feet. Ranging left now. Still moving down that left sideline, and then on his own going out of bounds. And the Spartans get a big play out of their own territory. Justin Smith, the redshirt sophomore, making the play.
Justin Smith looks like he's playing in garden gloves. That is just a yellow color that is just really, you don't see too often. You like sleek looking gloves, maybe white, but those,
you're not going to miss them.
You're not going to miss him.
Going to miss him.
Almost look like the Playtex gloves.
That's right. Their own 35. Here's a draw left. On his feet, still a Savage. And inside well into Bulldog territory. Falling down and drugged down there inside the 40-yard line is Savage.
Good run. He steps out of some tackles, cuts back, and that's a big gain.
Two huge plays. Starting from around their own 2-yard line, the Spartans already find themselves deep into SC State territory after the fumble. Quick pass blocked again at the line. I think that has to be at least the fifth one we've seen here tonight.
Yeah, Roderick Perry, Richard Jr., getting his hands in the passing lanes. And, you know, you don't have to sack the quarterback. Just knock the ball down. They want to throw it. You don't give somebody an opportunity to catch it, that's a win for the defense.
Spartans really like that quick pass out of the hands of Savage. Getting to the line now will be second and 10.
Those are my favorite gloves. I'm loving those gloves.
I know where they are. Here's a handoff and nice move back inside. Still on his feet is Hewlett. Left side and into the end zone. Touchdown, Spartans, and they answer back.
A great design for the Norfolk State Spartans. But there's, I think, a flag down, and I'm not sure if this is not after the fact. The coaching staff for the Spartans kind of asking the same thing.
He has that feel. Yeah, you can see it at the five. And it's against the Spartans. Holding. So it's a spot foul. You still get a good chunk of yardage, but you have to wipe out the score.
You wipe out the score.
It's big.
It's huge. And I think it's just somebody downfield as a wide receiver trying to assist the rusher. And great moves.
Again. Nice moves inside.
I like the blocking scheme there. Bring the wide receiver over to catch the defender.
And now it will be in trouble. Carter, and he just throws it left-hand side. It will be picked off. No, incomplete, they're saying.
I don't know about that one.
Quincy Hill trying to make a play. coming back on that ball. He had the best play on it out of anybody. I'd love to see that again. This is not lacking for any kind of entertainment.
No, and I think.
Goodness, here it is.
I think that looks like a catch to me.
Bobbled around.
Hands underneath, though.
As far as we can tell.
Hands underneath.
Second down and 10. After what is called an incomplete pass, and a golden opportunity there for Hill to force a third turnover for the Bulldogs tonight.
It wasn't a bobble. Probably could have got the call.
There's a handoff left. This is Brent. And he just bowls his way for about 3 or 4 yards. Bring up a third and long situation, about 6 or 7. Here's that play again, Steve. Here's Hill getting underneath that. And let's see.
Bobble.
There's a lot of bobbling. Yeah.
But he still gets his hands underneath the ball.
I don't know if he completes the catch. His body shields it away there at the very end. You got to complete it all the way through.
You do.
And I didn't see it.
We didn't see it. We didn't see it.
Say he didn't do it.
Right.
Trips right now to 3rd and 7. Bulldog defense has done a great job almost getting Carter. He will run left, though. Spin move, and I think it's just shy of the first down. We'll see where they mark it. Yep, about a yard shy.
And that almost was a recipe for disaster for Norfolk State, but Carter gets out. He goes for about 9 yards. I think here you have an opportunity for a chip shot field goal, D. Hansen, and that'd be a 25-yarder.
From the left hash, Josh Nardone, who is perfect on the year, 2 for 2. Both in this range, around 20, 29 yards. And a timeout taken, or flags fly.
This is a delay?
Delay game. Too close? This isn't a punt.
Well, you know, sometimes you can flatten out the angle by moving back just enough. Especially if you have a good field goal kicker that can make it from 40 in.
As long as 26 on the year. So now he will attempt this one out from about 30 yards out. Big kick to get up by 10, and it is good. 9:53 left in this fourth quarter, and how big was that holding call? Shaves 4 points off of the lead for Norfolk State. Coming back, the Bulldog offense onto the field, down by 10. You're watching MEAC Football right here on ESPN.
It's never been easier to watch ESPN3 games right here on Xfinity X1.
Introducing ESPN3 on Xfinity X1.
SC State has five games on their home slate. This is the first one, though. It is scheduled home game to start out the season when it's actually against NC Central on the 15th of September in Orangeburg, South Carolina. But of course, that game postponed. That will be rescheduled for November 24th and will be played between those two schools. But right now, SC State has bigger things on their mind, trying to get back on a 10-point deficit against Norfolk State. This fourth quarter with plenty of time left and an offense that now seems to have some quick strike ability. Here's the return on the kickoff. And to the 30-yard line. And now that you see a lot of stripping out there, as we've had more than just a few fumbles out there. That's Tayshawn Baines with the return.
Well, when teams know that you have the ability to put the ball on the turf, they're going to attempt to strip the ball from you because you're not keeping those 5 points of pressure against the body. And if you're careless with the football, the defense will test you to see if, in fact, you'll let it go and get a turnover.
Four turnovers in the game. Three of those have been fumble recoveries. First one was an interception by Hill. for SC State. Now with the football, down by 10. Keeper by Nick after showing right. And we had some really good carries by Jarius Jenkins, and he was the one that you saw at the top of your screen by himself.
Yes.
And you could see him a little bit also dismayed. Like, oh, if I just got in the ball.
Right.
It gains a yard, though, and it'll be second and nine now. Here comes some edge pressure show by the Spartans, and now Nick will approach the line for maybe an audible. And to his right is Green. For Jenkins, excuse me. And he'll go in and stay in to block. Nice throw and catch at the 45, 15-yard completion. And a first down.
Caldwell, the redshirt senior, coming in on a nice deep in route past the first down and goes down and corrals and ensures that that ball is caught.
A little low, able to make the play. As the 45-yard line of the Bulldogs pitch left. Here's Jenkins now. Lowers that right shoulder and gets near midfield.
I like that. You know you're going to have contact with the defenders coming at you. Cover up that football first and square your shoulder pads so that you can be a big target and get everything you can out of the run.
Redshirt sophomore out in Neesis, South Carolina, is seeing a little bit more action here. And every time he's really touched the football, he's gained some really good positive yardage for this team.
I like his upfield lean as well, finishing the run.
4 yards that time. Back to pass is Nick. A little bit left, caught inside the 40, and a little yak to get to the 30-yard line. Gets another first down for the Bulldogs. This offense seemingly now can't be stopped.
Wolverine on this reception and a really good route to sit down on the sidelines and then to get some additional yards after the catch.
Nick with the option down, pitches it. Jenkins breaks it back in. There's a flag on the play. This could wipe out a sizable gain of nearly 13 yards by Jenkins.
Really good offense by South Carolina State.
Really is.
It's just, you know, something here and there is stopping these guys. A fumble inside the five. Now this could be brought back because you in the official, you see that with the C on. That's a new added official to the crew and the penalty.
Chop block against the Bulldogs. That's a big one. Not just a hold there. That's 15 yards. And bring it back near midfield now. 45. Offense for SC State keeping things together, though. Even when these things do happen, they've been able to stay focused.
Well, you don't need to get everything back here. You got to think in threes. So if you can get maybe 8 or 9 yards.
25 needed for their first. Try to get something here. Nice flash right. Caught in a lot on that one. In fact, there might be about 20, 22 yards on that little pitch and catch out flare out right-hand side. Completed to Alex Scheifert. Freshman.
Scheifert does a great job to get his body forward and then cut inside D to get additional yards like you mentioned.
Second and 7 delay on the run by Nick, and he'll lean forward to that first down marker, but he'll be about a yard and a half shy.
Nice little stutter step to get more yards out of a play up the middle. Quarterback draw and a keeper to the right side. And had he not lost his balance, he could have tried to make it a foot race.
Nick is not all that big. I mean, he's 6'1", 170. He's able to elude tacklers that much easier.
As the game has gone on, you know what happens now. He's Nick at Night.
Jeez. Third and one coming up here for Nick at Night. Blitz up the middle, throws it right, and that will be incomplete and a little mix-up on communication, I believe, there between the receiver and the quarterback.
It was, but I think it's this is close enough to go for fourth and one. You've got to get some points, and you know you could say, hey, let's take the three now, but I like the decision of South Carolina State to go and get a first down.
Well, Bredson is the kicker. He's 0 for 1 on the season as a block on that as well, so maybe there's another reason for that and going for it. Little movement there, not called, throw right, it'll be incomplete. Are they going to say it's a catch?
But I don't know about the spot. And right there, Nick, just a little more effort, and we wouldn't have to hold your.
It's very close. Yeah.
We're going to have to hold our breath here to see.
In fact, the Spartans contend it's not a completion. I'd like to see that again. From all accounts, that looks like a catch.
Well, it's not the catch. I think, unfortunately, it's the
lob. Well, we wouldn't even be looking at the down if he didn't catch it in the first place.
Correct.
So now we will have the chains come out. Boy, this is going to be a close one, and this is a big one for both schools.
I'm thinking it's just short by the nose of the football.
The Spartans don't get it. And that is going to be shy of the first down. Good call, Steve. Half the length of the football. Valiant effort to get underneath that football and make the catch.
Yes.
Austin Ruger, the tight end, but it's all for naught. Well-designed play, but had they been up a little bit more, might have been able to get in there for an extra yard or two.
South Carolina State is just, it's unfortunate that just by the slightest of things, they are not converting.
It's been somewhat of the story of the game. You have a huge explosive play that, aside from that, all these other drives have gotten just this shy. Talk about a game of inches.
Yes.
Four down for the Bulldogs, and this defense has done a great job of keeping their offense in it, and they do it again.
Unbelievable.
Nothing doing left side of the offensive line on the attempt by Savage to gain yardage, and he loses a yard.
And even
block runs, though, this is becoming an issue here for the Bulldogs.
And fundamentally, South Carolina State has played well even in that regard. But Norfolk State has come in here and really made just, I think, more effort plays.
14 points in the early stages of the game is holding up. So right now, as he states, outscored him since then 7-3. Here's another handoff and another yardage lost here for the Spartans.
Negative play. South Carolina State, the defense is just really giving it their best this evening.
And illegal formation there against will be declined against the Spartans.
Savage was just swallowed up by the front four.
Chad Gilchrist changing the momentum on the run. He didn't make the play, but he's definitely the one that funneled Savage into a bunch of other red jerseys.
He shot through. It's a run blitz, and you have number 11 all out trying to blow up Savage, but the line, they definitely corralled.
Here we go, third and 12. Spartans trying to keep this one going and have a chance to drain more time off the clock. Throw on a slant. It will be caught, but shy the first down by a couple of yards.
Good coverage by Alex Brown.
Talk about Alex Brown and the rest of this defensive backfield. If you remember, Winstead was on fire in the first half, and we haven't called his name much here in the second half.
Good pass by Carter.
Everything was good on that one.
But fourth down, you need to change the field position and punt this ball away.
Getty has done a good job of that. He's gotten really close on a couple of occasions. He'll be at his own 14. Nice snap back and a high kick. And bobbled on the return and then blasted at the 16-yard line is DeMarcus Doe. Tough starting field position. SC State needs a score on this drive. Down 17-7 at home to Norfolk State. You are watching MEAC Football right here on ESPN. Your scores. We're back here in Orangeburg, South Carolina. MEAC play here on ESPN. Dee Hansen joined by Steve Foster as the Bulldogs of South Carolina State looking for a quick score against Norfolk State, down by 10 with four and change left, and that's a good way to start. No, incomplete. Climbing the ladder, I thought that was a catch, a dynamic one at that, but it will be all Will Vereen could do to hold on to that football and just could not.
And the ball actually comes out after he hits the ground. So he secured it to the ground, but when he lands, the ball pops up. And that was a great choice.
Vereen's made it, has had a nice game here tonight, too. Made some key plays.
Yes.
Nick out of the shotgun again. Now he's throwing right-hand side. It is complete for a first down. 11 yards.
And again, this South Carolina State offense moving well between the 20s. It just seems not to be able to execute to put points on the board. I mean, except for an exceptional pitch and catch for about 80 yards. Pretty quiet.
Omar Cummings, another freshman getting into the mix with a nice play there. Nick working against this clock, ranges left and now throws middle of the field, caught and dropped. That one should have been secured and for a catch.
And those little things, you know, I tell people all the time, and there's a, it's like a flag on the play as well. It's the end of the catch that's so important.
Alex Seifert with the
illegal man.
Incomplete pass or catch there, and then illegal man downfield there for the Bulldogs.
So insult to injury, penalty declined. You'll have second down, but we're not certain. The yardage here will count that up. 10.
4 minutes to go in this football game. And SC State looking for somewhat of a miracle comeback here from Tyrese Nick, their sophomore QB. And that one will be caught at the 30, but that's not going to get much. And Dogs, and you said, Foss, you're not going to be able to get everything in one fell swoop, and you got to get a little bit more than 3 yards.
Absolutely. And that's the catch that needed to be secured. That type of catch needed to be secured on the last two, which would have picked up good yardage.
For Burrows here, Nick in trouble, though, and he cannot get out of the grasp at the 25-yard line of the Spartans' defense.
Blackwell.
Blackwell making the big stop on the play. And the defense for the Spartans, we already knew coming in they were good, but this time coming up when they really needed to here, the Bulldogs will more than likely have to go for it now.
Absolutely they will.
Avian Blackwell, all 305 of them. And Nick now, low snap, has it, needs 7 to keep this drive going. And that pass doesn't even reach its intended target. And Omar Cummings and a turnover on downs will spell certain doom here for the Bulldogs. And Norfolk State can now, with a 10-point lead, drain this clock. With 3:01 left and a first and 10 coming up deep here into Bulldog territory.
It's unfortunate because the Bulldogs have played well. They just couldn't get in the end zone. Something just didn't work, you know, inside the red zone for these guys. And unfortunate turnovers and different things like that throughout this game has really come back to haunt them.
Cool, calm, and collected is Carter. Jawan Carter out of the shotgun now. And he'll hand it off. Hewlett has had his moments, too, in a three-pronged rushing attack for these Spartans.
Hewlett had the most impressive run. He got called back because of a hold.
A touchdown got called back. A lot of that yardage able to stay somewhat secure, but a 10-point lead still looming large here. Draining that clock at 2.5 now. Norfolk State had lost their last 9 to this South Carolina State team. They won 2 years ago for the first time, and now they're looking for maybe a second straight win here this evening, as they will continue to run the ball and run the clock.
Wisely getting this clock down to 2 minutes.
Meanwhile, the Bulldogs licking their wounds, but for what had been an anemic offense and a defense that had given up over 36 points per game, much better effort on both sides of the football. And if you just think about the Bulldogs, how close they've gotten on a couple of occasions, especially two series ago when they were knocking on the door within the five and just turned the ball over. The outcome of this game could look a lot different.
Agree.
That's usually the difference between the teams that wins and the teams that lose. Here's a quick slant, caught, and that should be enough for a first down near the 12.
Good job there, picking out Ellington.
Backup tight end there to Anthony Williams. And now we're inching up on 1 minute to go in South Carolina State. We knew this a while back, not using their timeouts, willing to let this clock run. And will more than likely fall to 0-3 on the season. Norfolk State started out with a W and lost in their second game to James Madison, but that was a game that was called due to lightning, and they elected to keep the score at 17-0 and lose that game. So, in fact, they could look back on it and go, well, you know, we could be 2-0 if you just looked at the games that actually played out to fruition. But you have to agree on that, and that's what ends up happening here is NSU will go to 2-1 on the season. And not 1-0 in conference play.
And that's the saving grace for South Carolina State. Does not count against their MEAC stand.
Could be the last play. And surprisingly handing it off instead of just kneeling on it is Carter.
They're not old enough
Savage
to,
on the run.
To remember Joe Pisarcik.
Right. So. And that will conclude this game. And the second straight win for Norfolk State against a team that had been dominating them in this series up until 2016 and tonight. As Buddy Poe will fall here in MEAC play, he still has 94 wins, but now go to 34 yards for losses. And nice to see him with Latrell Scott in his fourth year at Norfolk State, giving some hugs. And now we have the line to shake hands as the Norfolk State Spartans get the victory on the road here against a tough South Carolina State Bulldogs squad.
And now you can see some of the highlights of this game, but not enough for the South Carolina State Bulldogs.
So for me, and along with Steve Foster as well, we're to say so long here from Bulldog Stadium in Orangeburg, South Carolina, where your final score again is 17-7 Norfolk State with the win against SC State. All games airing on the ESPN networks are streaming live. This has been a presentation of ESPN.